Hi, Alex here from redeveloper.com and welcome to another episode of LBTA Components Magic. And in this one, we are going to talk about how to cache your images. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, now, when you try to load a lot of images into your app from a server, you want them cached. What I mean is that once you download them, you don't want to download them again when the collection view starts to show them all over again. So for that, LBTA Components provides us a cached image view that we will use now. So let's take a look at how we are doing in our project here. And I will just simply build on the iPhone 10 simulator here, and as you can see, these are all loaded from the device, and they are from here, from our assets catalog. Now we want to load them from the web, and as I mentioned earlier, I have downloaded all of these images from idownloadblog.com and original Apple wallpapers optimized for iPhone 10. So if you want to go check them out, go ahead and do so at this link. What I want to do today is to load these images into our app from this site. And for example, when I try to load this first image, I mean this one, it has a download URL, and if I right click on it and copy link address, or I just simply click on it, you will see that it has this link to it. This is the download URL, and this is what we are going to use. So let's get back to our let's see here, our data source, and then we are going to add here a new logic, and that is, instead of using this image 1, 2, 3 and so on, we are going to use our posts structure with an image URL. So for that, let's go into models and let's create a new struct. I will just comment out all of these and type in let image URL, and we are going to make this a string, and then let's initialize it with image URL. It will be of type string, and self.imageURL equals image URL. Okay, now we have our post. If we build our project now, we will have some issues. Now let's go over, well, a few of them, and let us not start here. We will start with fetch users and posts. Now inside this function, we will create a new URLs constant, and it will be an array of our URLs. And for now, let us just use this single one of the first image. Let's copy that out and let's paste this in here. Okay, now we have an array with, of course, a single element. And now what URLs, if I could spell that out correctly. Now we can refactor this for loop, and I'm going to go like this: for URL in URLs. So we are going to grab each and every element of our URLs array. We are going to create a new post, and we are going to feed in our image URL, so the URL, and finally we are going to add to our posts with append and post. Okay, that is how you will feed this new array. And let's go over now, let's take a look at the other issues here. Now, inside our data source cell, that is this cell here, we have an issue because we no longer have our post's image name. And here we need to construct our image with our image URL. And this is where LBTAComponents CachedImageView comes into play. So I'm just going to copy and paste again this image view, and I'm just going to comment out for reference, and let's type in here CachedImageView, and the image view needs to be initialized as a CachedImageView. Okay, now once you have this, because you have image view as a CachedImageView, you can now access a very handy, let's just jump to our definition, a very handy function, and that is, let's just scroll down, load image with our URL string. And of course we may have an optional completion, but we will not use that at this moment. So what we need to do now is, instead of our adding our image view, let's just comment that out, we are going to construct it like so. So image view dot load image with our posts dot image URL, and the completion should be nil, or we could just simply omit it, but this is just fine. Now let's take a look at the other issues here. When we pass on the image name to the large image controller, if you recall, then we just pass on from our image profile data sources posts image name. So for now I will just comment this out, and let's just build and run and see if we do have one image cell posted there. And as it seems, we have, and we will have to wait just a few seconds for this image to be loaded, because it is indeed a large image. Okay, till then, let us just see what else do we need to do. Let's go back to Data Source Controller, or maybe by the rather yet, Data Source. Okay. Why we are not seeing any images, and that is because here we don't have a secure connection. And if we take a look at the log here, let me just go back here. It says app transport security has blocked a clear text HTTP resource load since it is insecure. So as of, I believe, iOS 10, we need to have secure connections. To override this, well, use this only in development mode. You need to add an app transport security, allow arbitrary loads. And of course, again, you should never use this in production apps, because it is highly vulnerable for outside attacks. So what you need to do here is go ahead and add a new field and type in app transport security settings. Okay, and now just right click on it. Let me just open this up and add this plus button and select arbitrary loads and set this to yes. Okay, this will do for this development example. And now let us just build and run again and see what happens. Hopefully we do get that image. And yes, we did get that image. Now, let us just fetch all of the images now. And I have already set this up inside my test in a project, and let me just find that list. Here it is, URLs, and I will just simply copy all 17 of them. Okay, let me just minimize that, go into our data source here and replace this URL. Okay, here we go. Let's just build and run. Okay, here we go. And we will slowly get these images loaded. Pretty good stuff. Now, here is what I want you to really consider and why you should use LBTA components is cached image view. And that is, let us just make sure that we have only one item here. So I just comment this out and type in here view dot frame dot width. And now we will just have only one image per row. Let's just wait for that. And as you can see, two images have loaded. And let me just scroll down here. And they are loaded, but as you scroll down, they are loaded again and again. Sorry, I just clicked on that. And if we just scroll back again, because the cells are out of the collection view's scope, they should be now again reloaded. But since we are using cached image view from LBTA components, these are no longer needed to be reloaded. That is why they are cached, and that is why this is a very, very helpful UI image extension, image view extension. Okay, and that is very, very important in terms of bandwidth and storage allocation. Okay, what else do we need to do? Let us just go and make this again, uncomment this, so we have three rows. And what else do we want to do? Let's just build and run and see if everything was as expected. And now that we have three images per row, you will see that it kind of lags, and till it launches, well, it just fetches those images, it kind of waits a little bit. And for that, we need to add something for the user, maybe an activity view controller or something like that. And we are going to add that. So let us just go into our cells class and user profile data source cell, and we are going to add here an activity indicator view. So view, let's just stop this, for some reason it is not responding. Okay, here we have our activity indicator view. It will be of UI activity indicator view, and let's construct it here. Activity indicator view. But before we do that, let us just start animating. Okay, and now we need to add this to our view. So add subview activity indicator view, and let us just fill with within our super view. So fill super view. And one last thing is that we want to stop this animation when we fetched our image. So in the completion, let me just type that in again. Image URL with URL string as post dot image URL. I believe that is what we need. And here we will, let's say, okay, and let me just type in here, activity indicator view, stop animating. So let's build and run and see what happens. Oh, of course we need to call it with self, because we are inside a closure. And here they are loading, and the activity indicator view is spinning around till they are all loaded. Pretty good stuff. Now, next up, we want to finish off by implementing this logic that we want to send this image to our large image controller, and that is fairly simple. Let's go back to, I believe, where is it? It is in the data source controller, and here in our did select item at index path, we are going to add our image name. But before we do that, we need to know that we are providing an image URL. So let's go to large image controller and change some things. First of all, we should remove this image name and add an image URL. And that will be of type string, and let's make it an optional. Next up, we need to change this image view. Let me just copy it out and paste it down below here and comment that out again. And this time again, we will use our cached image view. Okay, let me just change that. Good stuff. And now let us just go down here. Yes, we need our load image changed. And again, I will just comment this out and create a brand new function. Let me just give you some room here. And that URL will be of type string. And again, it will be an optional. Okay, let's unwrap this optional. I'm sorry. Guard let. Let's type in here URL, and it will be a URL, as we are just going to simply return. And now what we need to do is load the image. So image view dot load image, and let's see, with our URL. And finally, we need to call this in our view did load, load image with URL, and this URL will be our image URL that we have just created, image URL. And now we need to provide it in our data source controller. So let us just type in large image controller image URL equals our user profile data source dot posts index path dot row and our image URL. Okay, and that should take care of it. Let's build and run and see what happens here, and hopefully we will get what we wanted and we will have finally our finished app here. Okay, we are loading good stuff here, and let us just tap on any cell and we are ready. Okay, now that is it for your knowledge of LBTA components. Of course, you may add more sections or more headers or footers and different kind of UI collection view cells, but that is something advanced. And if you just take a look at the whole project that I have set up here, you can manage from here. Once again, let me just show you. LBTAComponents is on GitHub, and you can, of course, take a look at the documentation. Maybe give it a star because it deserves it. And I really enjoyed working with LBTAComponents, all of the free parts of it, the data source controller, the cached image view, and of course our UI view anchor extension. Okay, hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, and of course subscribe to the channels to see more videos about awesome GitHub repositories and other iOS coding stuff. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.